अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन, आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड। टुडे इन P6 वी हैव कवर टॉपिक नंबर 6.03, दैट इज साउंड वेव्स ऑन पेज नंबर 128। सो एज वी ऑल नो दैट साउंड वेव्स आर एक्चुअली द लॉन्गिट्यूडनल वेव्स, बिकॉज व्हेन द साउंड वेव्स ट्रेवल इट मेक्स द मीडियम मूव फॉरवर्ड एंड बैकवर्ड। दिस इज़ नोन एज द ऑसिलेशन। सो व्हेन द ऑसिलेशन इज़ फॉरवर्ड एंड बैकवर्ड एंड द मूवमेंट ऑफ द वेव इज ऑलवेज फॉरवर्ड, दिस इज़ नोन एज द लॉन्गिट्यूडनल वेव्स, बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ द ऑसिलेशन एंड द मूवमेंट ऑफ द वेव्स आर पैरेलल टू ईच अदर, दे आर इन द सेम एंगल, सो दिस इज़ द लॉन्गिट्यूडनल वेव। सो वी कैन से दैट साउंड वेव्स आर लॉन्गिट्यूडनल वेव्स। ऑल्सो वैन द साउंड वेव्स ट्रेवल इट मेक्स द एयर पार्टिकल्स स्क्वैशेस एट सम पॉइंट एंड स्ट्रेचेस एट सम पॉइंट्स। सो द पॉइंट्स एट विच द एयर पार्टिकल्स स्क्वैशेस आर नोन एज कंप्रेशन पॉइंट्स एंड द पार्ट वेयर द एयर पार्टिकल्स स्ट्रेचेस आर नोन एज रेयरफेक्शन पॉइंट्स। Actually, the parts where the particles squashes are actually the particles are coming close to each other, and the parts where the air particles stretches are actually the parts where the particles of the air are kind of far from each other. So this is how the air moves. This is how the sound waves travel. It makes the air particles squash and stretch at some of the points. So the parts, the particles where the air particles, the part where the air particles squashes are actually the parts or the points at which air pressure rises. And the part where the air particles stretches or they are quite far from each other, the particles are quite far from each other, is a point in a sound wave where the air pressure drops. Alright, so if you see the diagram over here, you can see these are the waveforms. And it can show you some of the rarefaction points. These are the parts which are the lighter are the rarefaction points, and it is written over here that this has the lower pressure, and the parts which are darker are showing you the compression points, and it is also written in the bracket that they have the high pressure. So this is how the air particles travel. Also, as you all know, that the sound waves are caused by vibrations. The sound waves are always made by vibrations. When we knock on the door, it causes the door particles or the solid particles of the door to vibrate, and then the vibration travels through the air, and the air particles also vibrate, and then it eventually travels to our eardrum, and our eardrum also vibrates, and this is how we are able to hear the sound. Also, when the whales are communicating with each other in the water, the sound waves are traveling through the water particles, and then it reaches to the other whale. This is how the whales are communicating in water. If I take the example of the sound waves traveling through the air, we can see most of the examples. Like, for example, if I am speaking, so the air particles around me are squashing and stretching, and this is how it can reaches the microphone of this mobile phone, and then eventually it reaches to your ears, to your eardrum. So right now, if I am speaking in front of you, so the particles of the air around me are vibrating, and as you all know that the sound waves are made when the particles of the medium vibrates, any medium, it can be any medium like solid, liquid or gas. And if there is a place where there is no medium, like in space, as we all know that the space is a vacuum, it means that it has no medium, it has no solid, it has no liquid and no gas. So the sound waves cannot travel through the vacuum. As we all know that there are so many planets, asteroids, stars, and there are so many collision and bombardments going on in the space, but we cannot hear any of those because the sound waves does not travel through the vacuum, because there is no medium in a vacuum or there is no medium in a space. But the light waves are independent of this. The light waves, we all know that the sunlight can reaches all the way through the space to the earth, because this light waves does not require any medium to travel. It is independent of the medium. All right okay, so diffraction of sound. Now, as you all know that if I open the window, I will be able to see the light. but I will be only able to see the light on the area where there is a window. Alright, because this light waves does not bend. The light waves does not bend around the corners. But if I open the window, I will be able to hear the sound even if the sound is coming from the house that is 4 blocks away from me. I will be able to hear the sound if it is loud, because the sound waves can bend around the corners, and because the sound waves, the wavelength of the sound waves are much bigger, and that is why it can be diffracted and bend to the corners of the obstacle that are present in our daily life. But the light waves, the wavelength of the light waves is much shorter than the objects that are present in our daily life, and that is why it does not diffract or it does not bend to the objects or the obstacles that are present in our daily life. That is why we are not able to see the light waves or the light bending to the corners or bend or falling on the walls that are present, the wall that is present just beside the window. We cannot see the light on the wall that is present just beside the window, because the light waves does not bend. Okay, so this is the topic that we have covered today, and your question answers for today is that you have to solve in your notebook is, you have to give the example which will demonstrate each of the following. That you have to give the example of one sound wave that can travel through gas, the sound wave that can travel through a liquid, and the sound waves that can travel through a solid. And question number two is, you have to explain that why the sound cannot travel through a vacuum. And I think you will be able to solve these two questions very nicely, because we have already discussed about it. Okay, so this is your homework, and inshallah I will check your homework in the next class. Till then, Allah Hafiz.